All right, so we have a spring that's attached to the ceiling, like you see here. And this sort of natural resting position we call equilibrium. Now we're going to pull it down 5 centimeters from the equilibrium and let it go. So think about what's going to happen. If we release this object down here, we would expect this to bounce up and then down and then up and then down. But because of friction and air resistance, the amplitude or size of the oscillation is going to decrease over time until eventually the object almost comes to a stop. So let's see if we can visualize what that looks like here. So there's time and here's my distance. Now we have to be a little careful here. This is a distance, this end of the spring is below the equilibrium. And so here we're 5 centimeters below, and so we start out with D being 5. It's kind of a weird down is positive situation here. So let's imagine what's going to happen. The spring is going to go down and then up and then down and then up, and the amplitude is going to get smaller over time. Now, I don't know yet exactly where 4 seconds is here. I'm probably going to draw it wrong, but that's okay. So let's go ahead and just imagine that this is 4 seconds. And after 4 seconds, the amplitude has decreased to 3. So let's think about the amplitude here. If we were to sort of sketch in the amplitude would be decreasing from 5 down to 3. But notice that we're supposed to assume that the amplitude is decreasing exponentially, which makes sense because it's not just going to decrease down and hit zero. It's going to slow down sort of quickly at first and then slower over time. So we need to sort of sketch in sort of an exponential amplitude there. So there is an exponential function describing the amplitude. So this is going to be the amplitude here. So now notice that we know 2 things about it. We know that at time 0, the amplitude is 5, and at time 4, the amplitude is 3. And so let's see if we can come up with an equation just for the amplitude. We're not going to worry about the actual spring oscillations yet. We're just going to think about the amplitude. So because it is exponentially decreasing, we can write the equation like AB to the T. We could also use AE to the KT if you're more familiar with that. Either version works just fine. Plugging in our first point here, we know the amplitude is 5 when T is 0. B to the 0 is 1, and so that tells us that A, the initial amplitude, is 5. We probably could have just guessed that from the fact that it's the initial value. Now let's use our second point here. The amplitude is 3. We know that A is 5 when T is 4. So we just plugged in 4 for T, 3 for the amplitude, and now we can go ahead and solve for B. So B to the 4th is equal to, we'll divide both sides by 5, is 3/5. So B is the 4th root of 3/5. You could come up with a decimal value if you wanted, but I'm not going to really worry about that here. So now we have amplitude equals 5 times 4th root of 3/5 to the t. So that's an equation describing my amplitude. So now let's think about the actual oscillation going on here. So we're told that the spring oscillates 12 times each second. So when we think about equations for sinusoidal shapes, we generally think about four things. We think about midline, we think about amplitude, we think about period, which then gives us the B in our equation, and we think about shape. I'll stick it up here, shape of our equation, you know, whether it's shifted or not, and whether it's a sine shape or a cosine shape. You notice here we're starting at the highest value, so our shape is a cosine. We're oscillating above and below the equilibrium, and the equilibrium is where we're measuring from. So in this case, our midline is going to be at 0. The amplitude, Now, normally we think of amplitude being constant. In this case, our amplitude is not constant, our amplitude is changing. So we're going to use this equation that we came up with over here to describe our amplitude. And I apologize for the small writing there. And lastly, let's talk about period. So I'm going to erase this value here because it's probably in the wrong place. And now let's take a look and see what we know. The spring oscillates 12 times each second, which means there's one oscillation, two, three, four, five, six oscillations, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So it'd be way the heck out here that we'd hit 1 second. So if we're oscillating 12 times in 1 second, how long does it take to complete one oscillation? It would take 1/12 of a second. So our period is 1/12. Now remember, our b in the equation is 2 pi divided by the period. So in this case, that would be 2 pi times 12 over 1, or in other words, 24 pi. So now that we have all the pieces we need to write this equation, so let's go ahead and write our final equation here. So d in terms of t. Now remember, an equation for a cosine function is usually amplitude times the cosine function. So instead of our usual, let me make some room here, instead of our usual, you know, a cosine b t plus the midline, instead of the usual constant here, we're going to be putting in this function. So the function 5 times the 4th root of the 4th root of 3/5 to the t is going to be, maybe I should use parentheses here instead, all of this is my amplitude. The amplitude multiplies the cosine function. B is 24 pi. Don't forget the variable t. Plus the midline, and in this case the midline is 0, so we don't need to add anything on the end here. And there is our final answer. There is an equation for the distance. The end of the spring is below equilibrium in terms of time.